Trust in him, make the difference. Come on. Amen. Do I have to, like, is this all, who to give me five to five to five? Who to give me a praise? Who won't give me a praise? Am I going to have to do that this morning? Right? Man, if there's a new song in our heart, how many of us have seen God provide in ways that nobody else can? Amen. How many of us bank on it day to day? I love that song. Some of you may be like, honey in the rock, why is that even in the scripture? It's in there several times. Deuteronomy, Psalm 81:16. The Lord said, oh, but he would satisfy you with the greatest of wheat and honey from the rock. He would satisfy you. See, when you know Bible, and Bible knows you, when you know God through the Word, in those times of trouble, in the times of excitement, you will know who to trust. Amen? And that's why we're here. We came today not to dress up and make everybody think we got it together. And we came today not even to feel better about ourselves. We came today to sit in God's presence with brothers and sisters. All of us the same, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Especially in times like this. And I'm going to have you stand. I'm asking you to stand for a reason. Guys, this has been a tough little stretch. I'd say tougher than a few stretches that I was in COVID, where I had like 17 funerals. Then right out of COVID, we had 13 back to back. This has been difficult because it's just different. We went into kind of this season with the Hickses and been praying for you guys. With Steve Heintz and his family, and been watching over and praying for them for the unexpected death of Kara. Cheryl grew up here in this church, and Philip and Jody's daughter, and then Coy passing away, and this evening from 6 to 9, while we're having the latter part of Fall Festival, and I want you to be a part of that. We'll be having the visitation and then funeral tomorrow at 4 p.m. here at the church. Not only with that, but Sherilyn Davis and her father, Steve Mayberry, passed. And you guys know I'm waiting to get the call from my brother-in-law. And many of you have experienced things that you haven't even told anybody about. And this is where I want you to know there's honey in the rock. There's water in the stone. There's manna on the ground. And that manna being there, remember how much were they supposed to pick up each day? How much? Just enough for the day, and on the day before the Sabbath, how much were they? Double. 2 days. That means that with him, it's always just enough, but with Him it's also more than enough. And wherever I don't go according to His plan, it spoils. There's an Ishmael. There are things that I don't want. Because what we know is the reality of the blessing. Amen. And because of that, we know that there's power in His plan. Our community has also experienced a very startling tragedy with, many of you know, Abby Bunker. Abby is what, guys? 17? Okay, somewhere in there, okay? Yesterday she had a very, very rough accident on the interstate, and she's actually in surgery right now. Sustained a lot of injuries. And it is very, very intense. She was moved from trauma to ICU last night, and now is in surgery. And I want to open up this altar that we would pray for her. Her dad is the pastor of True Vine Tabernacle, Josh Blunt. I've known Josh since the time I moved here to Statesville. He used to play music for me when I was a student pastor. And guys, listen, we all go through stuff, but my heart really goes out to Josh and Elizabeth right now because they're going through their grief, but I guarantee you they still have people calling them to tell them about their grief. And as your pastor, I don't mind any of that, but there are times that you just need to press pause so you can focus on your first ministry, and that's your family. Does that make sense? And I know that family will use this for the glory of God. And I want us to, if you're able to get on our knees or either stand here at the altar, and I want us to pray that God would sustain Abby's body and that God would heal the Mayberries and that God would heal the Hickses and that God would heal the Gallihers and that God would heal the Cheryls and the Heinzes. And those of you who are in this room that are going through difficulty that maybe nobody else knows. And so not only do I want us to pray for Abby and these families, if you got something heavy in your wheelbarrow, I want you to bring it to the altar. And as you bring it, believe there is honey in the rock. That's right. You don't have to wait for me to get ready for this prayer. We're getting ready to pray. To believe there is honey in the rock, that God would feed you of the richest of wheat. That He would allow there to be honey in the rock. What is that? That's impossible. Honey doesn't come from a rock. It doesn't come from a rock. It comes from a honeycomb. But God is able to do the immeasurably more than all we could ask or imagine. The song goes on to say, I don't need to worry. Everything I need, You've got. So I want you to take just a few moments. I want to ask you to ask the Lord to forgive you of your sins. I want to ask you if you're at the altar right now and you need somebody to pray with you or pray over your family or pray over your marriage, would you just raise your hand right now? Just raise your hand. Every eye's closed, every head bowed, just me, won't you? You say, Pastor, I want somebody. I need one of my deacons right here in the corner right next to Angie to just go and lay hands on this man right that just raised it right there. Thank you, Greg. There's someone right here. Female. I need a godly female. Mount, will you get these two right here? Thank you, sis. Anybody else? Maybe you're not here at the altar, but you're in the audience. You just say, I need somebody to pray for me right now. Would you raise your hand? You got her, Karen? Anybody in the audience? I just need somebody to pray for me. Just raise your hand. Right back there in the back, I need to, who do I have? Who do I have back there? June, are you back there? June Buckner? June, I need you to come over right where you see that hand. It's going to be to your left. Right this way, June. If you're watching by line, listen, we love you watching online. And we're praying for the popes, and we're praying for those of you who are watching. Thank you, Mama June. But we're not here to be a show. This is a church family. And so even those of you who are online or at the radio, I want to encourage you to stretch your hand right toward the TV. I'm not trying to sound like some TV evangelist, but I believe there's power in prayer because I know who we're praying to. Anybody else? Thank you, Lynn. Take just a few moments and ask the Lord to forgive you of your sins, that nothing would hinder our prayers. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this morning as a church family in need of you. We're always in need of you, Lord Jesus, but we know that there is manna on the ground, and we need you, Lord Jesus. We bow before you and ask forgiveness of our sins, that there be nothing that would hinder our prayers. Nothing in our life, nothing in our heart, nothing in our spirit that would hinder, dear Heavenly Father, you hearing. We know, Lord, that that which we're about to pray, you already know in perfection. Your will has already taken place, but Lord, you have called us to pray in faith, believing in your name, that which we would ask according to your will in your name, that it would be done. So, dear Heavenly Father, as we group together as a family and ask, we do lift up, dear Heavenly Father, the Galliher's and the Hickses. We lift up the Hines and the Sherrills. We lift up, dear Heavenly Father, the Mayberries and those who are attending to that family. Lord, my own family. And now, dear Father, we pray that your comfort would comfort them in a way that no one else can. And Lord, now we bow to ask your mighty hand to be upon Abby. Lord, as she is in surgery, we ask in the name of Jesus that you would take those surgeons, those attending physicians, the anesthetists, dear Father, the nurses, everyone who is in that OR, everyone who is in that hospital attending to her, to use them as your choice instruments to minister life and health to Abby. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, for her because we know, Lord Jesus, that I believe you will use this for your glory and give her a testimony that she would share and her family would share about the greatness of God Almighty, your greatness, Lord. We ask, Lord Jesus, that there be no damage in her brain, dear Father, and that her lungs and her organs, Lord Jesus, would be fine, that the fluid, that wherever it is in her body, that you would remove it, Lord Jesus, that her bones would begin to heal and mend even now. And Lord Jesus, that you would bless this child. We ask God that you would give her that abundant life on this earth, and we pray this in agreement in the name of Jesus. Lord, bless Josh, Elizabeth, and the three boys and little sister, or four boys, Lord, that you would comfort and encourage them, Lord, even now. And Father, that their church family would gather around them, Lord, and support them, and Lord, that people would be sensitive to allowing them, dear Father, to be attentive to their family. I ask, Lord Jesus, that you would do this. I ask, dear Heavenly Father, for a healing. I ask, dear Heavenly Father, for you to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or imagine. Now, Lord, for my friends who have brought things to the altar, I ask, God, that you would heal and restore. I pray, dear Heavenly Father, for individuals who can't get out of their own way, that you would help them repent, run to you, and begin to live a new life with gospel-centered emotional intelligence and sensitivity to serve their family. I ask, Lord, that you would do that. I pray, Father, that you would restore marriages. I ask, Lord, that you would alleviate financial burdens and heal of sicknesses, dear Father, that those who are grieving and silent or have desire in their heart that they are struggling with, God, would you hear, mend, and heal. Sustain us. Those who have raised their hand, Lord Jesus, attend to those needs. And I pray that your power would make it whole and make them whole. So, Lord, as we gather together to worship, let us worship with spirit and in truth. As we give, dear Heavenly Father, let us not shrink back, Lord, in our giving. But, Lord, as we were at the one-day offering, Father, let us continue to grow. Let us continue to believe you. Continue, dear Heavenly Father, to provide that manna. And let us honor you in worship. Worship of giving. And, Father, as we get into your word, I pray that you would speak to us in a way that the Holy Spirit would convict. And I trust you for this. You are all that we need. And it's in the name of Jesus. Church family, can we celebrate the Lord right now? We celebrate Him. I'm going to ask, come up with a name for you guys. We're going to call you the Beulah Boomers here for just a second. I'm going to ask this crew to take us back in. They're going to lead worship for our student ministry on fall retreat. And just, is that right, y'all? Oh, you're not. Okay. Well, I was just making that up. Y'all did that last year. But I'm going to ask them to take us back into this. Honey in the Rock, just the refrain. And when you get to that place where it builds, I want you to sing it as a confession. I know that wherever God is, there's a masterful plan. I know that whatever He's working on, there will be enough for me. I know that in my fear, He will give me confidence. I know that in this fight, He will fight for me. I know where I doubt, He will let there be faith. I know where I hurt, there will be comfort. I know where I can't believe, He will give me all that I need. Come on, church, let's sing.
Keep praying, you keep moving, I keep praising, you keep.
Caught up in this moment, Lord, to where we don't want anything from you. We just want you to have the holy hush over our lives, Lord Jesus, that the presence, dear Father, that awareness that your presence toward us is nearness is our good. Lord, I thank you that the greatest promise of all, Lord Jesus, the greatest promise of all, Lord, is your presence near us. Thank you, Lord, that I can trust you, that your word says, never would you leave me, never would you forsake me. And that's not just for me, Lord, that is for your children here at Beulah and wherever someone calls upon the name of the Lord. I thank you, Lord, that your word is full of where you showed up when no one thought you would. While the darkness and waters troubled the earth, Lord, your spirit hovered over and you spoke life. Lord, the day where Adam and Eve hid from you, you walked in the cool of the garden and you saw fellowship with them, your presence near them. Lord, throughout time, you've been there, Lord Jesus, when Abraham and Sarah had no children and they were barren and they were discouraged and they tried it on their own, yet, Lord, you showed up with a promise. Father, when Moses ran from you, showed up in a bush on the backside of a desert to remind him he had been called. When Samuel was called, Lord, and sons of priests, Lord, were evil, you showed up in a voice and you called him. Ruth was alone and her husband had died. You provided, Lord Jesus, a Boaz. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that your word tells us that it was in moments you were with David before Goliath, and Father Daniel in the lion's den, and the fourth man, you were walking in the fiery furnace. So, Lord, I know trouble doesn't trouble you. I know, Father, difficulties does not make it difficult for you. When there was no boat, Lord, you walked on water. Father, I thank you that even your name, as you broke into humanity, you said of Jesus, his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. I thank you for your presence. Lord, we want to be a church like the psalmist said, Lord, let me be like a weaned child in his mother's lap. Father, not that we're coming to be blessed, not that you owe us anything. We just want you. I want to be that kind of person, Lord. I want to be that kind of pastor. I want my family to be like that, Lord, to where we're caught up in your moment. I want, dear Heavenly Father, our church, Beulah, to be a church to where we know you're with us. We know your blessings are come. But when you really scale it down, what we want is we want you. Never want to leave. Never rush it. Never hurry to get out of your way. Lord, we would follow you. I believe you for this, Lord. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus. Just to take you. Find some folks. And-